do I know?
We're going to analyze the physics behind this scene from Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse.
That's all it is, Miles. A leap of faith.
Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger? Like, what's up, danger?
Made them myself. They fit perfectly.
Can't stop me now!
Travel 200 miles, I'm knocking at your door. And I don't really care if you ain't
gonna go.
What's up, danger? Don't be a stranger. I'm right here, at your door. Danger.
We're going to solve for velocity, acceleration, kinetic energy, and net force. Because this movie is animated, we're going to have to make some assumptions about the scene. The first assumption is that Miles weighs 73 kilograms. The second assumption is that this is a perfect system, so no energy is lost and there's no air drag. The final assumption we have to make is how far he falls. As you can see, we don't know exactly where he fell from on the building. There are also slow motion shots like this one, so we can't rely on the time in the movie in our calculations. The movie is set in New York City, and the only building with this triangular design is the One World Trade Center. The real life building is 541 meters tall. We're also assuming that he was falling into the ground, not this ledge, because the World Trade Center has no ledges like this. So because we never got a clear shot of where on the building he fell from, we're assuming he fell from halfway up, which is 270.5 meters up, which is right about here.
Okay, so now we can solve for gravitational potential energy, or UG. The equation we're going to use is gravitational potential energy equals mass times acceleration due to gravity times height, or UG equals MGH. We can plug in his weight of 73 kilograms, the acceleration due to gravity of 9.8 meters per second squared, and our assumed height of 270.5 meters to get his energy in this scene, which is 193,515.7 joules. Because energy is transferred when he's right about here, his kinetic energy will be that value because we are assuming that no energy is lost. Using this value, we can solve for his velocity at the moment before he swings back up to the top with the equation kinetic energy equals 1/2 mass times velocity squared. Doing some math will give us his velocity of negative 72.81 meters per second or negative 162 miles per hour, which is faster than a human's terminal velocity.
As far as net force goes, because we're assuming that there's no air drag, the only force acting on Miles is force of gravity. This is easy to calculate because it's just mass times acceleration due to gravity, which is 73 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared, which is negative 715.4 newtons. From here, we can calculate Miles' acceleration as he falls with the equation F equals ma. We know that Miles' mass is 73 kilograms and his net force is negative 715.4 newtons. So basically, his acceleration is negative 9.8 meters per second squared. Funny how that works.
Okay, so let's watch the whole scene now.
Miles power with a blindfold on. Mama always asking, where did I go wrong?
Took you long enough.
What's up, danger? What's up, danger?
Now see this spark in you. It's amazing. Whatever you choose to do with it, you'll be great.
Our family doesn't run from things.
You're the best of all of us, Miles. You're on your way.
When do I know I'm Spider-Man?
You won't.
Spider-Man is halfway up the One World Trade Center with a gravitational potential energy of 193.5 kilojoules. Like, what's up, danger? Only the force of gravity is acting on him, giving him an acceleration of 9.8 meters per second squared. As he falls, his gravitational potential energy transfers to kinetic energy, which means his velocity is increasing. Danger.
Made of myself.
When his kinetic energy reaches its maximum here, Miles' velocity is negative 72.81 meters per second. Can't stop me now. 200 miles, I'm knocking at your door.